You're unbelievable. You've got an opportunity here, but you're too weak to fight. She needs you. Oh, what the hell? You both make me sick. I'll find another officer to escort you back.
He's wrong. I might have needed you once, but that was a long time ago. So you don't have to worry about me landing on your doorstep, okay?
Oh, I wasn't worried about that. I know you wouldn't want to. I know what you think of us. And that's the part I don't like. Because I blame myself. Yeah, well, let's just forget it, all right? Oh, yeah? We could do that, or we could talk about it. Please, Margaret. Please. Merle is under the bed.
So how are you going to get her out?
I can't. You'll have to.
That's your job.
Which I've tried to do, but she won't have a bar of it.
So?
The girl is under the bed crying and will not come out for anyone but you. Do you want an officer to get her out?
No. I want you to get her out.
Look, you're a school teacher, not a bloody psychiatrist. Now, will you please go and get Merle?
Why? Because you're giving up again?
Fed up to here with all this crap about giving up, okay?
It's not crap, it's the bloody truth. You've been giving up ever since you took your daughter's life. Why?
It's got nothing to do with you.
It bloody well has if it means I've got to do your work for you. Now why? Why did you fight to cope for all those years and then
give up? Because
it
was over. There was nothing to fight for after Linda died.
It was you.
So?
So, why didn't you fight for you?
Because I'm not bloody worth it. I killed my own daughter and I'm not bloody worth it.
What you did wasn't taking the easy way out. That took an enormous amount of courage. I think that's something you owe to Merle as well. Hmm? You're screwing yourself up feeling guilty about Linda. You can't let yourself do that to Merle. You're always going to be more than just a friend to her. Not many people get a second chance for themselves like this.
Lurch, you scared 3 days' growth off me.
Sorry.
Well, what's the matter with you? You look like your best friend just died.
Oh, big joke.
Yeah, well, if you want to cheer me up, you do better buzzing off.
That'd be right. Want to be alone with a freak, do you? Well, you call her Joni now.
Hey, what is this?
Well, you tell me. I've seen you, Reed. Well, one minute you're telling us to get her and the next minute you're chatting her up.
Yeah, well, so maybe I've got my reasons.
Well, what are they? What's going on?
I'm sorry, Lurch. I just can't tell you, mate. You're going to have to trust me.
Mate? That's a joke.
If you're going to carry on like
this... All right, I'm going. And while I'm at it, I'll see a screw about shifting back to me door.
Yeah, maybe you better. Hell, who needs it? Go on, rack off!
You come out, Merle, and you come out now.
Can't you get Tom? I hate it under here.
Well, come on out.
I'm not gonna. I'm not doing nothing for you.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, but it doesn't make any difference. I'm still your friend, whether you like it or not.
Don't believe you.
It's true. You don't stop loving your friends just because you've had a misunderstanding. You know that as well as I do.
Room service. Leave on the champagne. Reed.
Reed? Bloody hell.
About bloody time someone showed up.
Been looking for Lurch.
Oh, Grain, she's probably out looking for you. No wonder we never get anything done.
When have you been the quiet achiever?
Just get the stuff out of the dryer, will you? I'm running out.
Thanks, Brum. I'll take over for a while.
Oh, good. Another entry for the Happy Smile competition. This motel finally getting to everyone, is it?
McPherson wasn't looking too blue. She's nearly wetting herself in the corridor. Where they taking her?
Got a visitor. Gotta hand it to Vic. She knows how to get the best out of life in this dump.
Lisa, you okay?
Oh, it's just that time of the month.
Oh, shut up, Brumby. Look, why don't you take a breather? We'll cover for you.
Gotta talk to you, Alice.
Oh, shoot.
Private, outside.
You got it. Look after the press, Brumby.
Look after the press, Brumby. Shut your mouth, Brumby. Stand on your bloody head, Brumby.
It's a nice day for a walk, Lisa, but... You said you wanted to talk. What's wrong?
You tell me.
What are you on about?
Rita, I saw those books she's been reading down the flat.
Well, it's just some...
She's got cancer, hasn't she?
We better be getting back. Come on.
Cut the crap, Alice. She's me mate, and if that's why she's sick, I want to know.
She's not even talking to me. I've even moved me stuff back to the dorm.
They could fix it, can't they?
She's dying, Lisa. No one can do bugger all.
McPherson! You bloody idiot, I could have been Ferguson!
Nah, your head's not big enough.
Yeah, well, I'll knock yours off if you smoked all of our profits. Now, where's the rest? That's 60 bucks, you greedy bitch!
Not me, babe.
Oh, what do you reckon? Your visitor took a cut, eh?
Spider. Give her the economy for 5 minutes, we'd be exporting sunnies to the Poms.
Well, come on, we're down on kitchen duty this summer.
Oh, gotta work this out first.
Look, we'll give them the joints already rolled. That way we can spread them out thin. Make a couple of bucks anyway. Cookie. Yeah, I can see that. Now let's go!
Cookies!
That's what Spider do.
Make them up into hash cookies.
I'd get off. You'd waste them doing that.
Depends on how many you make and on how much you put in.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah. And on whether or not you put in any at all.
I thought you said you were smart. They're not going to fall for that.
When they see what good stuff it is, they'll be queuing up for miles.
I reckon I'm walking it first.
No, no, no. Now, come on, girls. We've got the tea to organise.
Oh, please, Mervyn, they're for Rita.
Yeah, is there something to cheer her up?
Rita's on a special diet, so all the more reason why you can't.
Oh, bugger it.
Oh, hang on, got an idea. Hey, Mervyn.
Oh, Mervyn, we just stopped tea. I haven't got time.
No, listen, we still want to do it for Rita, so why can't there be help this much? You must have a recipe somewhere.
Well, maybe. Look, there's too much to do yet.
Oh, come on, Mervyn. You've seen how down Rita's been looking. We just want to do something to show her that we're thinking of her. We'll make up for it time-wise, promise.
Well, all right. But you'll have to be quick, and I'll be supervising to make sure you do it right.
No worries.
There you are.
Why did you leave me behind?
Because I had to make a decision very quickly, and it was the wrong one.
You're never wrong.
It might seem that way, but just because a person uses big words and knows lots of things doesn't mean they're always right. If I'd fallen over and hurt my ankle, you wouldn't have left me behind, would you? In that respect, you're a hell of a lot smarter than me.